The Raiders donned a Halloween costume looking nothing like the team that just beat the Chiefs in today's 34-14 loss to the Bills in Buffalo. Hello and welcome to Vegas Nation. I'm Bryan Salmond, and turnovers really do the silver and black in. Derek Carr was not on top of his game, throwing two interceptions. The Raiders lose two fumbles, but put the ball on the ground four times, and the man who we thought was back, Amari Cooper, well, he turned back into David Banner today. Five receptions for 48 yards. The Raiders fall to 3-5 on the season. For more on the game, let's head to Buffalo with Raiders beat writer Michael Gehlken and columnist Ed Graney. Guys.
Yeah, thanks, Brian. We're at New Era Field here in Orchard Park, New York, myself and Mike Gehlken. Michael, 34-14, midway point has arrived for the Raiders in the season. I don't know if anyone really expected them to be 3-5. Or let me ask you this. Should we be surprised? Were the projections at the beginning of the season because of what happened last year perhaps a little too high? Are we seeing that now?
Maybe. I think we're seeing different things. I think we are seeing a team that went 12-4 last season, that won five games decided by 3 points or fewer, that won nine games that were one-score margins. And there is a bit of a regression, but you look at this game, they weren't even close. You know, last year's team was forcing turnovers. This one, they not only didn't force any turnovers, but they failed to protect the football. Jalen Richard muffed two kickoff returns. He was able to recover those two, but not able to recover a punt return fumble that he had. That cost them 3 points. DeAndre Washington, another running back who was stepping in to play some Marshawn Lynch, has the ball, heck of a play by the defense, quite frankly, and stripped out of his hands on a short catch, and it's caught midair, 40 yards the other way for a touchdown, and Derek Carr with two interceptions. One cost him 3 points. The other one ultimately will ice this result.
So 34-14. Also want to ask you, Marshawn Lynch did not play. He'll return at Miami next week. How much, if any, when it's 34-14, it's really hard to say one guy was going to make a difference, but did you see things early in the game where perhaps drives could have been extended, or was his absence really not any issue here?
No, I think you saw Jamaze Olawale convert a 4th-and-1. You saw the fullback later convert a goal line chance, and that's how the Raiders scored their first touchdown in the opening drive. I think what was costly was first Jamaze Olawale suffering a hamstring injury on a long kickoff return, so he became unavailable. That hurt this team.
There you have it. 8 games in. They're 3-5, now headed to Miami. Michael will head to Miami with them. Heidi and myself, we're going to go to New York. That's where the Vegas Golden Knights are. I believe we're a hockey team at this point, or until proven otherwise. Adam Hill will join us there as well. Look for all our coverage from today, guys, at reviewjournal.com, at Vegas Nation. Back to you guys in the studio. 34-14 final here from Orchard Park.
All right, thank you very much, guys. Of course, we have Gilberto Manzano, the NFL writer for Review Journal, here on our brand new set. You can see him in all of his glory. We're going to talk about the Raiders and their turnovers today. I mean, that really was the story and why they lost this game.
Yeah, especially after scoring that opening drive touchdown, then you have those fumbles, and then when you're on the road like that, you don't want to turn over the ball. And I think it turned those turnovers into 13 points. So right there, that kind of sums up the game. And then you have Marshawn Lynch there. Maybe that wouldn't have happened. I know we kind of bash on him for his rushing yards and attack, but he's a guy who keeps the ball secure.
And then also, they started off the game great. I mean, after that first touchdown, they go right down the field, they score, and then from then, they couldn't score at all, really, it seemed. Dinkin and Duncan, I mean, what's the difference between the offense last year when they were great and the offense this year?
You know, it's so strange. We thought they were back on track from that Chiefs game. You know, Derek Carr had 400 yards passing, and Amari Cooper had 200 yards receiving. Then you get the opening drive, and then after that, it was the same old Raiders from, you know, the 4 week losing streak. So it could be something where just the play calling, Todd Downing, you still got the star players there. You still got Cooper, Crabtree.
He even added a player.
They added Jared Cook and Marshawn Lynch, but they're going back to that, like you said, dinking and dunking. They're not getting down the field. They're taking their time. They're very slow out there. I think we have to accept the fact that this is not the same Raiders team as last year. They're not an explosive team anymore. This is who they are.
Who they are 3-5, and that's the old Bill Parcells, you are what your record says you
exactly
are.
Exactly.
Maybe one good thing they can take away from this is the fact that the next team that they're going to play are the Miami Dolphins, who scored as many points as you and I scored in their past game.
That could be a positive there. I know they're going to Miami. It's going to be a tough road matchup, but that team is probably the worst offense in the whole league. So it could be, again, we keep saying this could be a game they kind of break out, but it's already, you know, 8 weeks in, like, does it really even matter to this point? Are they, like, already out of it?
Give up on the season?
It feels like maybe you have to, like, regroup, and I don't know, but 3-5 is a big deficit, especially halfway point right now.
And one last thing to talk about, the defense, which had been pretty good. They're, I believe, a top five defense inside the red zone entering this game. I mean, they gave up some points and they gave up some yards. They probably should kind of throw away today's game. Maybe.
It wasn't, you know, that bad. I know Tyra Taylor had his moments, and obviously LeSean McCoy, you know, torched them. But it's just they don't get those turnovers. They have no interceptions for the first 8 weeks. I think that's a record ever. Never been done. I know last year the offense was helping the defense, and now the offense is struggling, and you're not getting those turnovers like the Bills had today for 13 points. The Raiders are not doing it all year, so both sides are pretty bad right now.
Ah, but both sides are pretty good. Both sides of this table are pretty good. Gilberto Manzano, the NFL writer for Review Journal, thank you very much, my man.
No problem. Thank you, Brian.
All right. Well, something has to give as the Raiders play in Miami next week versus a Dolphins team that just put up a grand total of 0 points versus the Raiders. So for all the guys, I'm Bryan Salmond for Vegas Nation. See you next time.